And welcome back to our election countdown coverage. We continue by taking a look at one of the most solidly blue districts anywhere in the country. The 4th Congressional District, which includes St. Paul and much of the East Metro, has been a DFL stronghold. Eric Chaloux explains.
We're here in South St. Anthony Park in the 4th Congressional District. This mostly urban district holds a record. That is, for one of the parties on the ticket. They currently have the longest winning streak that goes back decades.
I was talking more about the process.
Eugene McCarthy made headlines running for president in the 1960s, but back in 1948, the Democratic Farmer-Laborer Party member was first elected to the U.S. House. Ever since, the DFL has held the 4th Congressional District seat.
It is, you know, ensconced in a very Democratic area. You can go to other parts of the state where it's more competitive.
We caught up with the University of Minnesota Public Affairs Professor Larry Jacobs, who says the 4th is one of the most liberal voting blocks in the state. At the heart of the district, the city of St. Paul.
I like to think of Minnesota as not purple, it's not red or blue, it's polka dotted. We have got some bright red polka dots like Tom Emmer's district. We've got some very bright blue districts, and the 4th is one of the bluest.
This is a sample ballot for the 4th Congressional District. This race is right down here. Three names, but let's first start with the one at the bottom, the incumbent, the DFL's Betty McCollum.
With many crises in our nation.
McCollum, a former school teacher, was first elected to Congress in 2000. She became only the second Minnesota woman since statehood to be elected to Congress. This time around, McCollum is campaigning on these nine issues, including the environment, health care, along with social justice and equity. Moving up the ballot, you can see the Republican, Gene Rechtzigel. He's a self-employed farmer, property manager, and self-taught legal expert, according to his campaign website. Rechtzigel has run for Congress before. In 2020, the Republicans' campaign is built in part on a flat tax, changing Obamacare and border security. The Grassroots Legal Cannabis Party has Susan Sindt on the ticket. The small business owners' top issues include campaign finance reform, ending the war on drugs, and combating global warming. Three unique candidates, one trying to keep that winning streak going, the others trying to make history themselves by snapping that streak. I'm Eric Chaloux, 5 Eyewitness News.